Welcome to Query Builder Tutorials. In this tutorial, we will learn how to design and select a query visually, wrap it into a subquery, navigate through a query using document outline. You can open Query Builder using Start Page or Toolbar. Your query will be displayed visually on the diagram. To use Query Builder, drag the required objects from Database Explorer. Joins were created automatically. To view these joins, just double-click them. By default, Query Builder is loaded in the Select type, but there are other types that you can switch by using the pop-up menu. To exclude columns that are not needed in the selection, check only the ones that are required. Selected columns are automatically displayed in Tabbed Editor. Let's execute the query and look at the data it returned. From the resulting data, let's select cities, names of which begin with the letter C. To do this, let's open the Where tab and create the corresponding condition. As you see, filtering was applied successfully and we received the requested data. Let's change the query so that cities, names of which begin with the letter C, are omitted in the result. As you can see, code completion suggests relevant keywords. The changes are automatically displayed in the Where tab and filter. Data is received in correspondence with the specified condition. These two tables can be converted into a subquery. To do this, let's use the wrap to subquery's functionality. Now tables are transformed into a subquery. Drag the required object from Database Explorer. Let's select the required columns. Now let's join the table and the subquery by sales territory key. You can execute the root query. For this, let's click Execute Current Statement when the Root tab is active. And now we can execute the subquery. To do this, let's click Execute Current Statement when the subquery tab is active. You can view the query structure using the Document Outline window. In this case, you can see the subquery and the root query. Using Document Outline, you can easily navigate through all query elements. If you accidentally forgot to save the query and close the application, or if the application crashed, not a big deal, dbForge will automatically save your data. Let's open the application and then open the Restore tab. As you see, the query has been successfully restored. You have been watching Query Builder tutorial. You can download dbForge Query Builder for SQL Server from dvart.com. Thank you for watching.